గౌరవనీయులు పెద్దలు రాష్ట్ర క్రీడా శాఖ మంత్రి వర్యులు శ్రీనివాస్ గౌడ్ గారికి గౌరవనీయులు స్థానిక శాసనసభ్యులు కాలే యాదయ్య గారు ఆరిఫ్ సర్ అండ్ ఆఫ్ కోర్స్ ది స్టార్ ఆఫ్ టుడేస్ ఈవెంట్ ఆర్ ప్లేయర్ ఛాంపియన్ ప్లేయర్ మిస్ జ్వాలా గుతహన్ హూస్ నేమ్ ది అకాడమీ హెస్ బిన్ నేమ్డ్ అండ్ ఆఫ్ కోర్స్ an inspiration to many many youngsters and many many you know in the sporting fraternity across the country Jwala my compliments to you to Kranti garu to Elan to the entire family on making a wonderful wonderful facility right here my compliments to the entire team that has put their heart and soul and you know really sweat it out in coming out with a wonderful facility my compliments to the entire team who's been part of this effort I think what goes into from whatever little I know about sport like I sir aap log sab bhul gaye aise main urban development ka minister hu IT ka minister bhi hu but main badminton association ka bhi president hu sir aap bhul gaye sab log I'm kidding of course so I think what goes into making a city or a state really a beehive of activity for sports is really two things one we need you know those poster boys and poster girls and role models I think we have them in abundance in Hyderabad and Telangana we have Jwala we have so many sporting stars and sporting legends really in our own city I think for the kids to draw inspiration from secondly I think what's even more important is creating facilities which are world class in nature these centers of excellence which can actually serve as breeding grounds for young children to come train under you know competent coaches competent you know training staff and be able to face the world I think we have these two things now falling in place beautifully with Gutta Jwala center of excellence opening right here in Hyderabad but I do believe there is scope to do more in fact I think Jwala needs some support from government as well I promise you we will make it happen you had asked me in the past myself and sports minister garu we will definitely support you and I do believe that this will eventually become a factory of champions you will create more and more champions who will possibly go on to win badminton championship all England you know and the prestigious marquee events wherever they are held across the country across the world in fact I was just checking notes with Arif sir I was asking him you know a country like China aise kitne facility rahe honge China mein maine unse abhi pucha he said they must have hundreds and if not in thousands they definitely have them in hundreds now what really goes into as honorable sports minister was lamenting come olympics you know come world badminton championship or any world class event you see certain countries winning over and over and over that's because the system there is in place and the system is so refined and so much encouraged by the government locally there that they are able to produce champions consistently but in India today if you see someone like Jwala who's become a champion and you know who's won so many titles over the years it is primarily because of her family who's put in so much effort and so much of their own resources into making her a champion I think that is one thing that needs to change we need not celebrate our champions once they achieve glory we need to create infrastructure so that we create more and more champions like Jwala and that is what the new sports policy the honorable minister was alluding to will focus on in fact it's not just the players I think that need to be rewarded it is their coaching staff and the coaches who are fundamentally you know there guiding them day in day out who kind of actually are the most unrecognized in fact in a way if you have to put it unrecognized people you know who do not get all the visibility so to speak when I say unrecognized I mean they don't really get the visibility that is required who also need to be supported my compliments to Jay Prakash garu because I think sir this wonderful facility has come up thanks to you and your largesse because as Jwala and Kranti sir was pointing out I think thanks largely to you for coming out with a bold idea giving her the much needed encouragement thank you very much you just added you and Jwala together have added a beautiful new facility for the city of Hyderabad for the state of Telangana my compliments to you on that as well and like I said the comprehensive sports policy under the chairmanship of our sports minister is coming up and I do believe it will be like in every case that Telangana has set its eyes on we have come out with a pioneering and a benchmarking policy Even the sports policy will be comprehensive. It will most certainly, under the leadership of our sports secretary, Srinivas Rattugaru, and sports minister, Srinivas Gowdgaru, tappakunda idi migitha anni policyla madiriga deshanike margadarshakanga mana kreeda policy kuda undalani cheppi manaspurthiga korukuntu, kevalam champions ne kaadu, champions venuka unna coaches ni, vaari venuka unna training staff ni kuda gurtinchi gauravinchi వారిని ఇక్కడ తీసుకొచ్చినప్పుడే ఇట్లాంటి ఛాంపియన్స్ ని ప్రొడ్యూస్ చేసే ఫ్యాక్టరీస్ మరిన్ని తయారవుతాయని చెప్పి కూడా బలంగా విశ్వసిస్తూ, భవిష్యత్తులో మంత్రి గారు చెప్పినట్టు గౌరవ ముఖ్యమంత్రి గారి ఆశీర్వాదంతో తెలంగాణని క్రీడల్లో కూడా ఒక అగ్రభాగాన ఉంచేదానికి అందరం సమిష్టిగా ప్రైవేట్ సెక్టర్ కానీ, స్పోర్టింగ్ లెజెండ్స్ కానీ, స్పోర్టింగ్ ఛాంపియన్స్ కానీ, గవర్నమెంట్ కానీ కలిసికట్టుగా నడిస్తే తప్పకుండా సాధ్యమవుతుంది. జ్వాల గారికి ఈ అకాడమీని రన్ చేయడానికి డెఫినెట్ గా స్పోర్ట్స్ అథారిటీ ఆఫ్ తెలంగాణ నీడ్స్ టు పార్ట్నర్ విత్ హర్, స్పోర్ట్స్ అథారిటీ ఆఫ్ తెలంగాణ నీడ్స్ టు వర్క్ క్లోజ్లీ విత్ హర్. రానున్న రోజుల్లో గ్రామీణ ప్రాంతాల్లో ఉన్న క్రీడాకారుల్లోంచి కూడా మంచి వాళ్ళని తీసుకుని రావాలి, పైకి రావాలి అన్నప్పుడు డెఫినెట్ గా మరింత సపోర్ట్ కూడా అవసరం అవుతుంది. కాబట్టి ఐ హోప్ అండ్ ప్రే దట్ స్పోర్ట్స్ మినిస్టర్ అండ్ సాట్స్ కెన్ వర్క్ టుగెదర్ విత్ ఎమినెంట్ పర్సనాలిటీస్ అండ్ స్పోర్టింగ్ లెజెండ్స్ లైక్ జ్వాలా గుప్తా.